Yo, what's up, guys? It's Rob, and today we're going to be looking at the GameSense Radar. This is a slow-controlled mousepad that has just been released by GameSense. This is their first mousepad. Here is their card for anybody interested. And huge shout-out to GameSense for sending out this mousepad to me. They actually sent out the XXL version, which is pretty big. It's 900 millimeters by 450 millimeters, and the thickness is 3 millimeters. It also comes in another size. The other size is 450 millimeters by 450 millimeters, which is a square, and also the 3 millimeter thickness as well. I actually have the XL version right here. They didn't send this one out to me. I bought this XL version, and as you can see, they're pretty much identical. There really isn't any major difference between them other than their size, which is of course how it should be. And the packaging is pretty simple. They come in this box. You just open the box like this. Nothing special, but pretty nice and simple. And both of these mouse pads actually laid flat right out of the box, which is amazing to see. There's nothing worse than getting a new mouse pad and having to wait for it to lay flat. It can definitely get pretty annoying, and I mainly used the XXL size, so this one is pretty much still new, and it stayed in the box for the whole week that I used this mouse pad, and when I took it out of the box, it still laid flat with no issues, which is amazing. So the XXL comes out to $50, and the XL comes out to $30, which I think are good prices, especially for the XL. $30 for what you're getting is amazing, and I really did enjoy using this mouse pad. You get a lot of control, and it is very soft and smooth, especially when it comes to the glide of the mouse. I really had no issues whatsoever, and even with mouse feet that are definitely worse or just scratchy on rougher pads, they feel smooth on this mouse pad, which is really, really nice to see. This also does not have a coated surface, which means that if it does wear out over time, it will take much longer to do so. And I also live in Texas, so no matter what temperature or humidity it was, the mouse pad was completely consistent and felt great throughout my entire time with it. So I have used the XXL mouse pad for a week. And well, I took this XL out of the box and I used it for a bit and I saw no difference in terms of performance or anything like that, but I will be making an updated video maybe a month or two from now still using the XXL version, and I'm going to keep this back in the box and I will see how the radar does over time, of course. And then after that, since I really won't be using this XL one, I will probably give this one away once I make that video in a month or two. So like I said before, the mouse pad does have a lot of control and a lot of static friction as well. It is pretty slow, which is completely fine for someone who is more interested in having control and more stopping power with their mouse pads. And also, the surface is extremely soft and comfortable. And for the stitched edging, I didn't really feel it when I was playing in game. I don't necessarily plant my whole forearm on my desk or mouse pad, but it does rub against the stitched edging sometimes, and I really had no issue with this. And for the stitched edging of the mouse pad, it is a little bit higher than the actual surface of the pad, but I really didn't have any issues with this. I had no irritation or anything like that on my forearm. It is slightly higher, it just isn't too noticeable. I wouldn't recommend playing with a long sleeve though, because it does slow you down a decent amount, and before these mouse pads, I would use the Odin Infinity Hybrid and the Artisan Hein. Using a long sleeve with those mouse pads was much better when I was using it with this mouse pad. So for the XXL, you really don't have to worry about it slipping around because it's so big and normally you have things on it. But when I used the XL, I still didn't really have to worry about it because this rubber base is amazing. As you can see, I'm trying to move the mouse pad. I'm using a lot of force, and it is moving, but it's not moving as much as other mouse pads would, and it definitely does not move when I'm playing in-game, so it really isn't something that you should worry about. I do know that some surfaces can be more slippery than others. This is a custom desk that I made, homemade, and it just has a stain and sealer coating, so that is the type of surface that is on my desk, and well, it works really well for this mouse pad. I never had it slipping or moving, so that's always a huge plus. So the mouse pad is pretty soft, but you can't really dig into it with the mouse or your fingers. unless you're like just intentionally trying to dig into it like this. It is a soft surface, but you need a decent amount of force that would never be applied when just using a mouse normally or when playing in game. It's kind of insane that this is GameSense's first product, because it honestly is an amazing mouse pad. It's definitely comparable to the speeds of the GSR-SE and the Inked Gaming mouse pads, which are two mouse pads that I own. The main difference is that this mousepad is not coated like those, which will definitely make it much more durable. And like I said before, I will be testing that in the future once I put a lot more hours into this mousepad. So would I end up recommending this mousepad? Yes, I definitely would, especially for $30. It really is a steal. Getting a control pad with a smooth glide that isn't affected by humidity or temperature and does not have a coating is just pretty insane to me. At the XL size too, the XXL is going to be $50, which is getting a bit pricey, but for me, the XL size is definitely fine. So if you are looking for a slow pad that has a lot of control, I would definitely recommend this, especially if you are thinking about getting something like the Artisan Zero, but you aren't really looking to spend that much on a mouse pad, then this is definitely an amazing option. Thank you all so much for watching the video, and I'll see you guys later. Bye!
That was close. How did I miss? How did I miss? Oof. Impressive.